Welcome to all of you. My name is Joginder Tomar. I'm your friend and instructor. So today we will discuss about a very important topic, and the topic name is VPC. So VPC stands for Virtual Private Cloud. So Virtual Private Cloud is a kind of network in the AWS Amazon Cloud. So in this picture you can see we have created a network with the name 10.0.0.0/16. So it's a B class network. So out of this B class network we can divide many subnets. So we have created a subnet with the name subnet public, subnet private. So subnet public, subnet private, these are just the examples. We can create many subnets as much as we want within the 10.0.0.0/16 network. So out of this network we can divide many subnets, we can create many subnets. So we have subnet public. So subnet public is 10.0.0.0/24. So 24 is indicating here we have 3 octets towards the network site. 1, 2, 3. So 10.0.0, it means these are the 3 octets belongs to the network site. So every octet will contain 8 bits. So 8 multiply 3 is equal to 24. So that's why here is 24. So in every subnet these 3 octets value must be unique. So here we can see 10.0.0 and here you can see 10.0/1. It cannot be again 10.0.0. It cannot be possible. So two subnets cannot be same. So if we will create the another one more subnet, let's say subnet X. If we will create subnet X, then it can be 10.0.2.0/24. So like this way we can create many subnet out of the 10.0.0.0/16. So we can understand in a layman style or the language. So 10.0.0.0/16 is just like a big cake. So out of the big cake we can create many pieces. So many pieces as much as we want as per our requirement. So pieces out of the big cake is similar like a subnet. So we have here the subnet public, subnet private, subnet X, subnet Y. So as much as we want we can create many subnet, but all of the subnets are created out of the one network, that is 10.0.0.0/16. So further we will understand in this example. So we have a VPC here in this picture in the right hand side. So this VPC having the network 10.0.0.0/16. So out of this main network we created two subnets and we given the names subnet public and subnet private. Subnet public having the range 10.0.0.0/24. So here if you will see that 10.0.0, these are the 3 octets. So every octet will contain the 8 bits. So 8 multiply 8 multiply 3 is equal to 24. So 24 bits. So that's why here the slash value is 24. So these 3 octets value should be different in every subnet which we will create out of the main network. So that's why here is 10.0.1. here the 1 is different, but here is 0. So that's why this will made the subnet private as a different subnet than the subnet public. So here in the subnet public we have EC2 instance, and in the subnet private we also have the EC2 instance. So we can create many EC2 instances inside a particular subnet. So whatever the subnets we will create inside a one VPC, they will communicate with each other through the router. So this is a virtual router. So virtual router we have no need to create, it is implied automatically inside the every VPC. So every VPC will have a automatic virtual implied router. So we have no need to do any configuration, or we have no need to perform any command line instruction for creating the virtual router. So virtual router will be contained in every VPC. So with the help of this virtual router or the implied router, all the instances in a one subnet will be able to communicate with the EC2 instances of the other subnets. But all the subnets instances must belong to the same VPC. So let's understand further more. You can see here routing table here, and this routing table is connected with the subnet public. So here you can see here 10.0.0/24. So this is the subnet range, and here you can see IGW. IGW is a internet gateway. So internet gateway is a component which is connected with this subnet public. So IGW or the internet gateway will provide the internet connection to all the EC2 instances within a subnet. If the EC2 instance want the internet connection, that the subnet in which the EC2 instance is located, that subnet must be connected with the internet gateway component. If the internet gateway component is not connected with the particular subnet, that subnet will not get internet connection at all. So this subnet public is connected with the internet gateway component. It's a virtual component. So that's why whatever the EC2 instances which are placed inside the subnet public, they can get internet connection, they can access the internet. And in the route table here we need to define 0.0.0/0. It means the traffic can go anywhere in the internet. So this is representing the IGW address, internet gateway address. So here in the second subnet, which is a subnet private, you can see the internet gateway is not connected with the subnet private. So it means to say that this subnet private EC2 instances cannot get the internet access. So internet will not be accessible in the subnet private. And in the routing table, which is connected with the subnet private, is having the 10.0.1.0/24. And here the 0.0.0.0/0, it is not defined here. So because this subnet private will be isolated, subnet private will not get the internet connection. So that's why the internet gateway is not connected, and the 0.0.0.0/0, it is not defined here. So 0.0.0.0/0 we will define if we want the internet connection, and the internet gateway will be connected here. So I hope so the topic is very much clear to all of you, and let us understand further more information about the VPC. So during the creation of the VPC, we have to follow the sequence of the instruction. We need to create some components in the sequence. First of all, we need to create the VPC. We need to define a new VPC. So second component we need to create here, subnet. So third component we need to create internet gateway. And you know very well, internet gateway is used for providing the internet connection to a particular subnet. If you will not connect internet gateway to a particular subnet, then EC2 instances which are located in a particular subnet cannot get the internet. Another one is the create route table. So we need to create the third component, route table. So let us repeat it again. First of all, we need to create VPC. Second, we need to create the subnet. Third, we need to create the internet gateway. So internet, through the internet, from the internet, the EC2 instances can be accessible if the internet gateway is connected to a subnet. If the internet gateway is not connected to a subnet, then from the internet, the EC2 instances cannot be accessible. The last component, component number four, we need to create a route table. So we need to create as it is in the sequence. So now we are going to perform the lab on the AWS Amazon portal. So let's go to the portal. And our lab purpose is to create one VPC. In that VPC, we will create one subnet, and in that subnet, we will create one EC2 instance. And that EC2 instance will be accessible from the internet. So in our today's lab, we will perform this portion only. So let's go to the web portal. So here we need to type www.aws.amazon.com. So click on sign in to the console. So root user is already selected by default. Now enter the email address. So this email address we must have, which is already used for getting the AWS free tier subscription. So click on next. Enter the password. Click on sign in. Now we got successfully logged inside our AWS portal. So here on the top, you can see we have various regions. So we can select a nearest region to our location. So my nearest region, which is Asia Pacific Mumbai. The reason to select the nearest region is to avoid the latency. So latency will be very less if we'll select the nearest region. So now what we need to do, click on the services. Under the services, we need to go to the networking and content. So under the heading networking and content, we will find one component which is called as VPC. So click on VPC. Now click on your VPCs, and here you can see a default VPC which is already created. So but we have to create our own VPC, so click on create VPC and mention the name of your VPC. You can give any name which you required, which you desire to give. So I will give here a name, my VPC. So here CIDR value, so we need to give the network range. So network range I will assign here 10.0.0.0/16. This is exactly the network range that I told you already inside this picture, that is 10.0.0.0/16. Let's go to the portal. Now click on create. So the following VPC was created. This message will be appeared on the screen. Click on close. Now if you'll see in this picture, you can see what we have to do in the next step. So in our next step we need to create a subnet. So now let's go to the portal. So click on subnets, and we have already 3 default subnets, so we have to create our own subnet. So click on create subnet, give a name of the subnet, assign the name of the subnet. So subnet name I will assign here my subnet. So it is not necessary that if I have assigned the name my subnet and you also have to assign my subnet the same name. So you can assign any name, whatever the subnet name you wish to assign. So here my wish is my subnet. So here in the VPC select my VPC. So by you doing this one, this subnet will get associated with the VPC. So availability zone, you can select any zone. So but for the namesake I am using here AZ1, availability zone 1. So IPv4 CIDR block I will choose here 10.0.0.0/24. So you can see in this picture 10.0.0.0/24, exactly the same I am giving here. Now click on create, close. So I have created a subnet also, and the status it is showing available, and it is showing that this subnet is associated with the VPC, and this VPC is our VPC that we have created just now before. Now what is the next task we need to create? So next task we need to perform, create internet gateway. As I told you already, if you will connect the internet gateway to a particular subnet, then whatever the EC2 instances which are located inside a particular subnet could be accessible from the internet through the RDP or HTTP or any kind of protocol. Otherwise the EC2 instances we cannot access from the internet. If we have Linux based EC2 instances, we can access through the SSH from the internet. If we have the Windows based EC2 instances, then we can access from the internet through the RDP. And if you want to take the web based console access from the internet, we can use the HTTP or HTTPS protocols. But the thing is that here, main important thing is that IGW must be connected with a particular subnet. That subnet in C2 instances we can access from the outside if the IGW is connected here. if the IGW is not connected here, these EC2 instances cannot be accessible from the internet. I think so you are very much cleared with this point. So now let's go to the portal and create internet gateway. So click on create. Now click on the option internet gateways at the left hand side under the VPC dashboard. Click on create internet gateway. Mention the name of the internet gateway. Assign the name. I will assign here a name, my VPC hyphen IGW. So click on create. Close it. So now the internet gateway has been created successfully, but the state is, or the status is, detached. So it is not associated with the VPC that we have created. So in order to associate this internet gateway with the VPC that we have created before, we need to check mark this IGW and click on actions, click on attach to VPC, and click on VPC and select the VPC just now we have created before with the name my VPC. Click on attach and you can see the status has been changed here, and it is showing the attached. Before it was showing the detached. So now, as per our picture, what is the fourth step? The fourth and final step is to create a route table. So let's click on route tables, and here we need to click on create route table and mention the name or assign the name of the route table that you want to create. So my route table, you can assign any name, but for the namesake, just randomly I assign my route table name. So select the VPC, my VPC. So click on create, click on close. So we have performed all the four steps. So now what we need to do, we need to associate the route table with the subnet. So select the route table just now we have created with the name my route table. So this route table is a part of the VPC, my VPC, but this route table is not connected with a subnet. So in order to connect with a subnet, we need to perform the further steps. So you can see in the picture here, this is the route table, and this route table is connected with the subnet private, and this route table is connected with the subnet public. But now we are performing the lab task up to this portion. We are creating only the one subnet here. In our further sessions, we will create the two subnets also in the same VPC. But for today's lab, we are performing and we are creating only one subnet, which is the subnet public. So let's go to the portal, and now here click on subnet associations, click on edit subnet associations, and you can see the subnet just now we have created before with the name my subnet. It is showing with the IPv4 CIDR value 10.0.0.0/24. So just check mark this one and click on save. So with the help of this one, this subnet is associated with the route table. So you can say that this step we've performed successfully, right? So this step we performed successfully, and this route table has been added with the subnet public. So now we want internet gateway also should be connected with this subnet public. So in order to connect the internet gateway with this subnet public, we need to perform the further steps. So click on routes. Okay. So click on edit routes, click on, and here you can see 10.0.0.0/16 is here. This is the network range, right? Network range of the VPC. So we need to click on add route. So we need to define the route to, that is 0.0.0.0/0, and here the target is internet gateway. So click on internet gateway option, and you can see here my VPC-IDGW. This is our own created internet gateway is highlighting here. Just select this option, click on save routes, click on close. Now we have performed all these tasks here, right? But our next task for the testing purpose is to create the EC2 instance inside this subnet. So let's go to the portal again. So now we will create a new EC2 instance inside the on VPC cloud. So aws.amazon.com. So now you can see here under the services, under the compute, you can see EC2. So click on EC2. Click on running instances. Click on launch instance. And it will redirect us towards the step number 1. So choose an image. Choose an Amazon machine image. So we require to choose an image of the operating system through which you want to install an operating system in a EC2 instance. So let's choose here Microsoft Windows Server 2016 base. So this is a free tier eligible. So click on select. So step number 2, choose an instance type. So here this step number 2 is showing the combination of the multiple hardwares. So if you want to assemble a new PC by your own, what are the components you required? You require the hardware like RAM, processor, storage. So these are the main components you require, right? So here also you will find the same components here, which is a virtual CPU, one virtual CPU under the free tier eligible T2 micro, and 1 gigs of RAM, and instance types or instance storage type you will get it here, elastic block storage, right? So these are the combination of the hardwares which will be utilized during the creation of the your own new EC2 instance. So click on next. Now the number of instance, we want to create one only. Under the network, select my VPC, which is our VPC that we have created just now before. And under the subnet, so it is showing the availability zone. So click on the availability zone and auto assign public IP. So whatever the VPC you will create yourself, so it will be in this case that auto assign public IP by default it will be disabled, but in the default VPC it will be always enabled. But we are not using the default VPC, right? We are using here our own created VPC, which is with the name my VPC. So whatever the new VPC you will create your own, in that all circumstances you will get always auto assign public IP will be disabled. So we need to enable it if you want to run the internet connection inside. So we enabled, that's why. Now click on next. So click on next, and here click on add tag. So here enter the name, and here under the value we need to assign the name of the EC2 instance. So I will assign the name here Windows EC2. Now click on next, and here you can see under the type RDP is showing here. Under the protocol TCP, port range 3389, and the source you need to change here anywhere. Click on add rule. So under the add rule we need to select here all ICMP IPv4. So under the custom, under the source, click on anywhere. Now click on review and launch. So now on the final step, step number 7, it is showing you the summary, whatever the steps we have already performed in the wizard. So we can verify, we can view the summary of everything. If we will find anything incorrect or we want to change it, we can go back by clicking on previous. But we have verified everything and everything is correct as per our plan. Now we need to click on launch, and here it is, it will show you the option or the screen, select an existing key pair or create a new key pair. So here this key will be required to decrypt the password or for generating the password to get login inside the EC2 instance. If you lose the key pair, then you cannot get login inside the EC2 instance. So be careful and save this key pair in a safe location where you can find it easily. So here there is an option, choose an existing key pair. So you can choose this option if you have already created a key pair before, or you can choose the second option if you have not created any key pair before. So I will go with the first option, choose an existing key pair, because I have already created in my previous sessions a key pair with the name web server key. So check mark the option I acknowledge, click on launch instances. Click on view instances. So now the installation of the EC2 instance is in process. So we need to wait until the status will be changed into the 2x2 green and the color will be green. So let's wait. Now you can see here status checks, it is still showing initializing. Then after some time it will change the status with the 2x2 /2, or the 2x2 checks has been completed and it is showing the green tick here. So it means our EC2 instance is now ready. So now here is the time to access this EC2 instance through the help of RDP. So for that purpose we require a public IP. So you can see here under the description in the bottom, you can see IPv4 public IP address. So copy this public IP address and now go to run and type MSTSC. So MSTSC is a shortcut to access the remote desktop connection console. So click on OK. So now we got it, remote desktop connection console. So now paste the public IP address by pressing the key simultaneously Ctrl+V and click on connect. Wow, so we got successful connection access. So type administrator as a user account and the password that we don't know. So we will generate a password or we will decrypt a password. For that purpose click on connect, click on get password, and here click on choose file option. So here go to the file or browse the file which you connected with this EC2 instance. So I connected this file webserverkey.pm. Remember that the key pair file name will have the extension always .pm. So select this file, click on open, click on decrypt password and copy the password and paste it, click on OK, click on yes. So now you can see here we got successful RDP connection of our EC2 instance, and this EC2 instance we have created in our own VPC which we have created with the name MyVPC. So this RDP connection we got it successfully because the subnet is connected with internet gateway. So you can see in this picture, yeah, this is the internet gateway, and this internet gateway is connected with the subnet. If this internet gateway could not be connected with this subnet or the subnet public as the name we assigned here, so then this EC2 instance could not be accessible with the help of the RDP connection or any way from the internet. So let's see here. Yes, we can see the desktop screen. So you can see here this subnet is associated with internet gateway. So this is how the VPC we can create. I hope so. The today's topic is very much clear to all of you. Thank you for watching my video. If you want my new latest upcoming videos in future, then don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel, click on like icon, share it and press the bell icon also. Thanks once again.